Hello, we are headed into election season, so we do have a bond referendum on the ballot coming up, as well as a proposed extension to our physical plant and equipment levy. Today we're doing a little bit of myth busting about some concerns we've heard related to these two items. The first one is tax rate. Your tax rate will not increase as a result of voting yes for either or both of these options. As it relates to the bonds, the maximum that you can be charged in the state of Iowa for bonded indebtedness is $4.05 per thousand. We are already at the $4.05 per thousand, so there would not be an increase there with a yes vote. The physical plant and equipment levy is $1.34 per thousand, and again, you're already paying the $1.34 per thousand. So in both of those cases, if you were to vote yes, there will not be an increase in your property tax. Now, valuation will certainly and likely change over time. Your valuation is likely to increase, but that's not a function of what we're doing with the tax rate. Second item is we have lots of items on this agenda, or on this bond referendum, and some of them will begin immediately. So we'll do a Northern Transportation and Operations Center, that's because we've grown out our existing one, so that'll happen in the near term. We also have projects that'll be 6, 8, 10 years out. You may have seen the Northwest Track and Turf on there and think to yourself, that seems awfully new, and it is. That'll be a resurfacing and a re-turfing in the next probably 8 or so years. The final item is we get the question, how about if we just saved, or what would it look like if we just saved the money annually to do these projects? So what you need to know is this: we have two funding streams for projects and improvements in Waukee schools. One of them is the statewide penny, the other is the physical plant and equipment levy. They generate about $27 million annually. About $17 million of that is already obligated to bonds and our one-to-one buses, et cetera. So we only net about $10 million a year. And when you think about redoing furniture in a school being about a $750,000 project, redoing the carpet in the school about a $500,000 project, we have $1 billion worth of assets, and $10 million doesn't go very far when we're trying to maintain our facilities at the level that we've all grown accustomed to and expect for our student staff and each of us. So thank you, and thanks for taking the time to listen to this.